My name is Seth Kweku Bani, and today I'm going to show you how to design this.
When I'm up through the night, I can't turn down the noise.
Alright guys, so this tutorial is about how to cartoon yourself, how to turn any photo of yours into a cartoon effect. And so let's go to Photoshop. Let's drag our image in there. Let's pick this. Just drag it in there. Double click here and then type original. Okay. Convert it to smart object. Click on Control Alt and then I. And then make sure this chain is ticked. And then turn here to 1500. All right. Also make sure the resolution is 300 and click on okay. So Control Zero to bring this up. Let's duplicate this layer. Let's call it, go to filter, go to liquify. I'm using Photoshop CC 2020. And so this is what is showing. You click on the arrow over here. Make sure you click on all the chains. And then let's set here to 80. Let's set the height to 90. Let's set the width to 100. Let's set the tilt to 70. And then let's set the distance to 20. So you can click it. Let's check the preview. This is how it looked like. This is how it looks like now. Also, let's go to the math. So let's set the upper lips to 100. Let's set the lower lips to minus 100. Let's set the width to 100. And then let's set the height also to 100. Then let's close it. Let's go to the face shape. Set the forehead to minus 100. Let's set the chin to 20. Let's set the jaw line to 100. Let's set the face width to minus 34 and see. Let's click on OK. Let's go back to filter. Let's go to filter gallery. Let's go to the artistic folder. And let's choose poster edge. Then let's set the edge thickness to 0. Let's set the edge intensity to 1. And then let's set the posterization to 2. And then click on OK. Let's go back to filter. Let's go to sharpen and then unsharp mask. And then let's set the amount to 90. Let's set the radius also to 5. And then let's set the threshold to 10. And then let's click on OK. So you can see that the effect is coming out nicely. So click on original, duplicate it, and pull it up. Let's name it Outline Edges. Now let's click on the liquify here, hold Alt, and drag it on top of it, and release it. All right, so the effect has kicked in. Great. Let's go to filter. Let's go to gallery, filter gallery. Then let's go to artistic folder and then let's click on poster. Let's click on poster edges. Let's go to the thickness and let's set it to 0. Let's set the intensity to 1. Now to also see our effect, and click on the 100% and then click on fit in view so we can see what is happening over here. So let's push this to 6 and let's see. This is quite good now. Alright guys, so now you can click here to collapse it. Click here and go to soft light. And then let's set it to 34%. Click over here. Click Control, Alt, and Shift. And then click on E. Let's name it HPF for high pass filter. Now go to filter. Go to other. Go to high pass filter. This makes the edges stand out well. Set the radius to 2 and then click on OK. Now, if you zoom in, you realize that there is some colors in there. Don't want that color. So let's go to images. Let's go to adjustment and let's go to desaturate. It will take away all those color away. Let's go to the blend mode. Let's set it to soft light again. And then let's set the opacity to 50%. Let's put all of them in one particular folder and let's call it cartoon effect. So this is the original image we had, and this is your cartoon effect. Now you can click here, okay, come and pick any of your images, drag it in there, resize it, and then Control S to save it. So you can see it's saving over here. Once it's done, just go back to your document and you realize that the effect also applied to it as well. And so this is the original document, and then this is the cartoon effect as well. And so, ladies and gentlemen, this is how you design a cartoon effect of your own photos. And so guys, don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, and also leave some comments down there for me to review. I love you all. Peace out.